So, here it is, the comprehensive list of the 98 greatest video games of all time. Have your favorites made the cut? And which iconic game takes the top spot? Keep watching to find out. Pac-Man is one of the most famous arcade games of all time, and over the years, it has become a permanent pop culture staple. While the original Pac-Man deserves all the credit for establishing the franchise back in 1980, its sequel made enough small improvements to become the definitive version of the game. The differences between the two games are slight, such as new maze variations and more random ghost behavior, but they add up. Even today, Ms. Pac-Man remains a staple of bars and arcades, and for good reason, too. It's just that much fun. If you grew up playing PC games in the early 2000s, you're probably already quite familiar with Roller Coaster Tycoon. Developed almost entirely by Scottish designer Chris Sawyer, the original game took the simulation genre on an amusement park adventure. And while the franchise still continues today, nothing quite beats that original game. If you just want to play the easier parks and build a few quirky rides, you can. But if you really love deep diving into the mechanics of sim games, Roller Coaster Tycoon has plenty of added depth, too. It's pretty incredible how much Sawyer got right on the first try. Not every arcade game has stood the test of time, but Galaga has aged like fine wine. The game was made as a spiritual successor to 1979's Galaxian, which was itself inspired by the spacefaring combat of Space Invaders. A feast for the senses and a genuine challenge to boot, Galaga quickly forged its own identity as an all-time great arcade game. Namco has since made numerous sequels to Galaga, but none of them capture the simplistic magic of the original. That's probably why you'll find it included in so many retro gaming collections, and why every worthwhile arcade keeps a cabinet in stock. 9 Hours, 9 Persons, 9 Doors, also known as 999, jump-started the Zero Escape series. This visual novel is a story of 9 young adults stuck on a sinking ship. In order to escape, the player must solve several puzzles, and probably hit a couple of dead ends along the way.
Thanks, Junpei. I'm just gonna borrow this, okay?
While 999 was the first Zero Escape game to capture fans' hearts, its sequel, Virtue's Last Reward, is equally beloved. Both titles have since been bundled into a package called the Nonary Games, offering the chance to enjoy these stories on more modern consoles. Myst is an undisputed PC gaming classic, as well as one of the most famous puzzle games of all time. The game is basically a point-and-click adventure in which players explore a mysterious island filled with strange magical objects and intricate puzzles. Despite its simplicity, the popularity of Myst has endured for decades. Legions of Myst clones have been released over the years, and in 2021, the original itself was re-released in VR for the Oculus Quest. The game may have attracted some criticism for its slow pace and difficulty, but the sheer dedication of its hardcore fans stands as testament to the game's trailblazing reputation. The short runtime and low-key storytelling of Firewatch might not be for everyone, but many have found it to be a beautiful experience. Taking place in the Montana wilderness in the summer of 1989, Firewatch follows a troubled fire lookout who becomes embroiled in a strange mystery that parallels his own personal struggle. Critics have praised the game's realistic geography and attention to detail, while the strong writing and vocal performances will quickly engage players in the plot's grand mystery. The game's ending is melancholy and sparse, and may require a replay to fully understand, but Firewatch is more than worth that extra time. The World Ends With You is earned a reputation as a Square Enix cult classic. Neku, an amnesiac teenager, finds himself lost in an alternate version of Tokyo's Shibuya district. He soon realizes he is taking part in a mysterious contest known as the Reaper's Game, and teams up with a girl named Shiki Misaki in order to survive. Critics praise The World Ends With You for its emotionally evocative story and unique characters. The game's reputation has passed the test of time, too. Square Enix released remasters of the game for iOS and Nintendo Switch in 2018. And the game even inspired an anime series that aired in 2021. Many first- and third-person military shooters try to depict the horrors of war, but few games have done so quite as effectively as Spec Ops: The Line. The game starts off simple enough. A small team of soldiers must venture into the ruins of Dubai in order to extract a decorated AWOL military veteran. As the plot progresses, however, the player is forced to reckon with their own decisions and witness the brutal consequences firsthand.
Do you feel like a hero yet?
Spec Ops: The Line never pulls a single punch, making for a tough and even unpleasant gaming experience. That's the whole point, though, and it makes that point terrifyingly well. Sam and Max is based on a comic book series about the misadventures of the titular duo of anthropomorphic animal police. As the player wanders around each episodic level, they have to solve various puzzles using their wits, observation skills, and even the odd bit of cartoon logic. This all might seem pretty by the numbers, but the zany world of Sam and Max is filled with sights and sounds you won't find anywhere else. And that's to say nothing of the charming story and genuinely hilarious dialogue.
Max, you keep playing dead. I'll figure out some way to bring Teddy Bear and his factory to their respective knees.
I can't hear you, I'm dead.
If you're in dire need of a laugh, Sam & Max is a game for you. The Danganronpa games are visual novels, which means you get less of the RPG and action-heavy grind you might find in other games. That said, the stories they tell are compelling and thought-provoking, forcing you to really invest in the cast of characters involved. Danganronpa 2 and its predecessor Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc have closely related narratives, and they both eventually link into one cohesive storyline. As such, it's highly recommended that you play through both if you plan on playing either. Sly Cooper has been a traditional 3D platformer, but its sequel took the series in a totally different direction. Band of Thieves retains the 3D platforming of the original, but it also slaps on a bunch of exciting overworlds and playable heists. The game follows three master thieves, Sly, Bentley, and Murray, on the run from the police and criminals alike. Players undertake recon, tailing, and infiltrating missions before heading out on the final heist. Despite the shifting gameplay, Sly 2 stays true to the original's tone and storytelling. This is a different kind of sequel, and one that shows how shaking up a series can really pay off. In some ways, Journey defies genre. It's technically an indie platformer, following a lone figure on a daunting pilgrimage. The character learns about the game's lore through a series of murals, all while collecting pieces of a scarf that grants him the ability to glide greater distances. While traveling, the pilgrim can meet other players, each on their own journey, communicating with one another only via a series of chirps and musical tones. It might sound odd, but this vague multiplayer mechanic allows players to feel connected in a more emotional way than you might expect. Throw in some gorgeous graphics and an incredible musical score, and it's easy to see why the game was a hit with both players and critics. Gears of War 3 took everything that made the franchise's previous games so great and improved on them in numerous ways. The epic campaign allowed for four-player co-op, and the competitive multiplayer saw the addition of new modes and options to expand its appeal beyond hardcore gamers. Meanwhile, Horde mode was fleshed out with a fun base-building component and a system of progressive unlocks. Not only that, but Epic Games also brought in Karen Travis, author of the surprisingly great Gears of War novels, to work on the story, resulting in a third act for the trilogy that's packed with emotional thrills. Hades tells the story of Zagreus, the disgruntled demigod son of Hades who is trying to escape from his father's domain. This is a classic yet inventive roguelike that builds on the story as the players progress through it. One way in which Hades switches up the genre is by allowing players to lighten up the whole experience. The game features a god mode, which lessens the damage the player takes and raises the threshold each time they die. It also allows players to spend resources from past runs on power-ups like a heartier health bar, thicker skin, and other perks. If you're often put off by the challenging nature of roguelike games, then Hades might just be what you need. Beautiful Joe is a wacky spoof of Japanese superhero shows that incorporates elements of 2D beat-em-ups, platformers, and puzzlers. Traveling through different movie worlds and genres, Joe strives to save his love interest, Sylvia. The game's combat and puzzles revolve around Joe's ability to speed up and slow down time, making for a fun and novel style of gameplay. Even better, after every level, the player is greeted by a shop in which they can snag health upgrades, items, or new moves for combos, adding whole new layers to an already solid romp. Devil May Cry 5 proves to be the culmination of every great element in the classic series, particularly when it comes to combat, and the four vastly different playable characters are why this hack-and-slash game stands above the rest. Nero relies on his exhaust-based sword and robotic arms, while V acts as a summoner. Virgil has flashy katana attacks that help differentiate him from the others, and with four stances and 12 weapons, Dante is the most well-rounded and complex of them all. Using all four is an absolute joy, especially since each level is highly replayable and combo options are almost limitless. In short, DMC5 is what every action game should strive to be. While virtually every Dragon Quest game is memorable, none reach the heady heights of Dragon Quest VIII, Journey of the Cursed King. Since the game was the franchise's first foray into 3D, the developers pulled out all the stops to provide a jaw-dropping experience, and they succeeded too. The story, music, and comedy are widely regarded by fans as top-notch, even in the normally hilarious Dragon Quest franchise, and the voice acting walks a fine line between emotionally grounded and enjoyably campy.
Hold your horses, Grandad. I thought it was Dalmagus we was after.
I am not your Grandad!
Not many game franchises survived the transition to 3D, but Dragon Quest VIII Journey of the Cursed King didn't just survive, it thrived.
Oh my god, who touched Sasha? Alright. Who touched my gun?!
Team Fortress was once the dominant class-based multiplayer first-person shooter on the market, a title it held for a long, long time. The original structure of the game made it both easy to jump into and incredibly complex for those who wanted to dive deep. 9 districts, immediately identifiable classes, and a handful of maps built with specific objectives in mind. Team Fortress 2 left major marks on the gaming industry, most notably helping to popularize the kind of class-based shooters that is so rife today. Its cosmetics-based free-to-play business model was similarly influential, but more than anything, Team Fortress 2 was just an unbelievable amount of fun. In Hollow Knight, you start out as a humble bug, exploring the dangerous caverns of Hollow Nest as you ascend your way to become a great warrior. With touches of Dark Souls in its world-building and exploration inspired by the Metroid games, Hollow Knight excels in every category. But Hollow Knight also creates something unique on its own too, featuring stunning environments and countless upgrades and abilities to unlock. As you dig deeper into Hollow Nest, Hollow Knight provides all kinds of new, hidden paths to explore, keeping the player engaged for hours and hours on end. Borderlands 2 is an improvement upon the first game in almost every way. Most notably, the game ratchets up the action and doubles down on the elemental damage, featuring incendiary, slag, corrosive, explosive, and shock elements. This elemental system was found in the first game, but Borderlands 2 ups the variety and incorporates each element into the game's near countless guns and weapons. The story is also more fleshed out in this game, which also boasts some great DLC, such as Tiny Tina's Assault on Dragon Keep and Sir Hammerlock's Big Game Hunt. A modern point-and-click classic, Kentucky Route Zero was released over the course of 8 long years. Across 5 episodes and 5 short intermissions, the game has you control many characters, but you begin simply as Conway, a man who needs to deliver a package across a strange and broken land. The end goal of reaching the intended address at Dogwood Drive is not as much the focus in Kentucky Route Zero as its characters and dialogue. The game deftly uses mood and tone to make sure the player relates to each of the characters, while melancholy folk music further sets the mood, sending the player on a surreal adventure into the dark side of the American South. Doki Doki Literature Club offers a unique, weirdly self-aware experience in a game that can be wrapped up in a couple of hours. It's also one of the creepiest games of its decade. The game has a few moments that might be considered jump scares, but it also develops an anxious atmosphere using visuals, music, and an uncanny ability to undermine your understanding of how this world works. Doki Doki Literature Club would later be followed by a remaster version called Doki Doki Literature Plus, an expanded story with extra content that is generally better rated by critics. But that game wouldn't exist without the foundations built by the superb original. There have been a lot of great Ratchet & Clank games over the years, but the best and most well-rounded of the bunch may still be 2004's Up Your Arsenal, the third entry in the series. It took all of the innovations from Ratchet & Clank Going Commando and tweaked them in meaningful ways. Ironically, the arsenal of guns was actually cut down, but each one that was included was given plenty of time and space to enjoy. The arena battles of the second game were also expanded, multiplayer options were added, and the series' trademark brand of cartoon comedy was never stronger.
Now you see us, now you…
Oh, crud.
Okami is a complete gaming package. The game is a feast for the eyes and ears, its story and characters really stuck with fans, and the gameplay is polished while also blending seamlessly into the unique aesthetics. While Okami is almost Zelda-like in its world and dungeon layouts, the game also distances itself from its inspiration by extending the ukiyo-e stylings into gameplay, namely by utilizing an in-game paintbrush through which players can affect the world. Really, the only disappointment here is that more people didn't buy the game when it was released. To put it simply, Batman Arkham City is Batman Arkham Asylum perfected. The game features the same fantastic, fluid combat as its predecessor, but Arkham City gives players even more gadgets to work with. Moreover, since Arkham City takes place in the walled-off section of Gotham known as Arkham City, the world is much bigger. gamers have free rein to leap across rooftops and glide as they see fit, all while exploring a story that is among the Caped Crusader's very best. All in all, Batman Arkham City set the bar so high that even its own sequels have yet to eclipse it. Horizon Zero Dawn tells the story of Aloy, a woman who travels through a post-apocalyptic world populated by backwards societies and robot dinosaurs. The mystery of Aloy's past and how the world ended up in this state drives the narrative, making up half the game's fun. The other half is the thrill of the hunt. Horizon Zero Dawn borrowed several ideas from Monster Hunter, as Aloy needs to dismantle these robotic beasts and collect their parts to craft new items and equipment. It's arguably a more engaging experience than Monster Hunter, however, thanks in part to its open-world gameplay and gripping plot narrative. In Psychonauts, the player takes control of Raz, a psychic circus performer who ran away from home to pursue his lifelong dream of joining a government-funded group of psychic secret agents. In each level, Rasputin traverses the often twisted minds of the game's characters, each filled with unique set pieces and heavy symbolism.
No! We don't forfeit! We're gonna beat you, Mr. Genetic Memory of Napoleon Bonaparte!
To add to the attractive insanity, every NPC is as funny as they are oddly proportioned, and the story walks a tightrope between serious, campy, and tongue-in-cheek without ever losing balance. And while Psychonauts shows its age in the graphics department, the game has lost none of its charm, quality, or polish. Outer Wilds is a first-person space exploration game in which progress is gated by knowledge. You are stuck in a time loop, reliving the last moments before the sun supernovas and your solar system explodes. If you want any hope of reversing this calamity, you must visit each nearby planet and translate the writings of an ancient alien race. Using just a small set of tools, the environmental and cerebral puzzles in Outer Wilds will test your memory and your ability to think on your feet. Progress is measured in each piece of knowledge gained, but Outer Wilds isn't afraid to let you die for making silly mistakes. At the end of the story, however, the game's constant sense of existential dread is turned into a kind of beautiful melancholy that masterfully rounds off the whole experience. Dead Cells combines roguelike replayability with Metroidvania map design. The game focuses on fast, enjoyable platforming and action through randomly generated levels. While it follows the age-old roguelike system of locking new weapons behind collectibles, however, later levels also hide permanent upgrades that players can use in earlier biomes to open new areas. As a result, players always find something new, no matter how many times they start over. What Dead Cells lacks in story, it more than makes up for in sheer entertainment factor. And the constant updates and DLC packages don't exactly hurt either. In Fire Emblem Three Houses, the player chooses to ally with one of three houses, subsequently leading a class of students through a series of turn-based battles.
What should we do, Teach?
Kill every last one of them!
Notably, Three Houses caters to the crowd that enjoyed the social sim elements from newer Fire Emblem games, allowing the protagonist to recruit most of the students and interact with them during bond-boosting tea times and training sessions. Aside from garnering near unanimous praise from critics, Fire Emblem Three Houses was also successful enough to win the Game Awards 2019 Player's Voice Award, beating out some of the year's most popular mainstream releases. The final outing for Yakuza protagonist Kiryu Kazuma, Yakuza 6 The Song of Life, is also one of the most memorable games in the franchise. The main town of Onomichi is a high point, gradually opening up as the game progresses and featuring all kinds of fascinating NPCs and questlines. Meanwhile, the game's combat, described by Kotaku as unexpectedly rich, is spruced up with outlandish special moves and a deep character skill tree. And of course, the narrative is extremely entertaining too, serving as a definitive and heartfelt conclusion to Kiryu's long journey. Diamond and Pearl began the fourth generation of Pokémon games and marked the core series' debut on the Nintendo DS. The hardware upgrade came with some big additions, most making the Sinnoh region one of the most beautiful and enrapturing locations ever seen in a Pokémon game. The sheer number of distinct areas, legendary Pokémon side quests, post-game options, and beautiful tunes made Diamond and Pearl stellar entries in a beloved franchise, and arguably the best the mainline Pokémon series has ever been. Shin Megami Tensei V is the latest entry in the Shin Megami Tensei franchise, which is the older sibling of the more popular Persona franchise. The game faithfully continues many of its precursor's hallmarks, such as the ability to recruit virtually any enemy and a battle system that punishes simple mistakes and rewards ingenious planning. However, SMT V also adopts new ideas to perfect the formula. Instead of funneling players through dungeons, the game boasts a large map for players to explore, and the combat system has been balanced to promote new strategies without sacrificing its mechanics. Some gamers might want to write off Shin Megami Tensei V as Persona 5 but harder, and while that is an oversimplification, it is also a glowing recommendation. The Phoenix Wright series has a simple concept. As upstart lawyer Phoenix Wright, the player is introduced to an eclectic cast and sent to gather clues before taking part in a hilarious courtroom showdown. After a dozen main games and spin-offs in, Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney remains one of the best games in the franchise. Each of the story's main three cases are filled to the brim with over-the-top and memorable characters, locations, and plot twists, making this feel like a classic collection of detective short stories. There is nothing quite like Katamari Damacy. The gameplay premise finds the player rolling up objects into an ever-growing ball of total chaos. And while that might sound simple enough, the game quite literally runs with it. This is one of the strangest and most whimsical games out there, and it's still a marvel to play. More than anything else, Katamari Damacy exudes style. The cartoonish visuals and outlandish cutscenes are especially distinct, but the soundtrack takes the spotlight, featuring music that outlets such as GameSpot have praised for being insidiously infectious. Basically, Katamari excels in pretty much every category. Alan Wake is an atmospheric third-person shooter, bursting with some of the best set pieces in gaming, and a love letter to writing, surrealism, and the horror genre itself. Writer Alan Wake has recently arrived in the Twin Peaks-esque town of Bright Falls, when his wife suddenly goes missing. Reality and fiction begin to blend as the player finds pages of Alan's manuscript that give crucial backstory and foreshadowed gameplay moments yet to come. The way the narrative is methodically unraveled makes it easy to become fully invested in its characters and reality-ripping conflict. And with a sequel finally in the works, it seems like fans might get a payoff to the game's infamous cliffhanger. The LucasArts team brought all of its adventure game experience to bear on Grim Fandango, a sprawling tale of a wayward Grim Reaper named Manny, who wanders the land of the dead in search of love and meaning.
Choo-choo, little buddy.
The mechanics here are sound, and the puzzles are fun to unravel. But what really pushes Grim Fandango to the top of its field is the unique and compelling nature of its smoky afterlife. Every character is brought to life beautifully, the locations are fun and interesting, and the jokes hit nearly every time. In brief, it's hard to find an adventure game better than Grim Fandango. Undertale is one of the most successful games ever made by a single person. Creator Toby Fox drew inspiration from the likes of Earthbound and Legend of Zelda to create the pixel-perfect graphics, music, and atmosphere of an early 90s game, with a little anime humor thrown in too. Undertale mostly differs from the typical RPG due to its combat style. Players have the option to choose between different actions like fighting or sparing a foe, and during the opponent's attack sequences, they must survive a bullet hell-style puzzle. The game also tracks your actions, making note of whether it's your first run or not, or whether you killed too many monsters in a previous save. It's unique, to say the least. On the surface, Eternal Darkness: Sanity's Requiem is a survival horror game that pits players against unknowable, godlike entities, taking clear inspiration from H.P. Lovecraft. Nothing horror veterans haven't seen before, sure. But Eternal Darkness has lived on in audiences' hearts and minds thanks to its sanity system. The lower the player's sanity meter, the more the game becomes rife with disturbing sights and jump scares. This system guarantees that no two playthroughs are the same due to the random nature of its scares. It also means that Eternal Darkness is a horror game unlike any other, thus guaranteeing its place in video game history. Pokémon Legends Arceus throws out many of the hallmarks of a traditional Pokémon game, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. For one thing, Arceus is more about catching Pokémon than using them to battle trainers and gym leaders. To its credit, though, the game makes each catch feel rewarding. While players can potentially spend countless hours wandering the vast and varied biomes on offer. And while Arceus isn't a true open-world game, it still nails the feeling of adventure and exploration that comes with one. With any luck, future Pokémon games will copy this formula, and maybe even perfect it. Star Wars: Knights of the Old Republic is a stunning combination of superb Star Wars storytelling and groundbreaking RPG mechanics. The game takes place thousands of years before the original trilogy, seeing the player on a quest become an immensely powerful and influential Force user.
All this time and you still haven't figured it out.
Knights of the Old Republic is an open-ended adventure that allows you to carefully craft your character's skills and make them exactly as good or as evil as you like. Along the way, you'll form a party of followers, encounter all manner of trials and tribulations, and experience one of the most shocking twists in video game history. All things considered, Knights of the Old Republic isn't just great for Star Wars diehards, it's also one of the best RPGs of all time. Originally released on the PlayStation 2 in 2008, Persona 4 perfectly combines storytelling, strategic combat, and relationship management into an experience that feels like living through your favorite anime. The game's mostly silent protagonist is sent to live in a sleepy Japanese town that is soon rocked by a series of brutal murders. Relying on the help of their closest friends and a healthy dose of magical abilities, players will solve the case, all while surviving high school and getting to know the town's inhabitants. The game is several dozen hours long, but tense combat and emotional character arcs keep up the momentum from beginning to end. Uncharted 2 is where the Uncharted series really came into its own, but Uncharted 3 keeps the pace and is arguably a more enjoyable experience. Along with the famous cargo plane sequence, Nathan Drake makes his way through several unique environments, each as thrilling as the last. It helps too that the gameplay style suits each section of the game perfectly. Platforming, brawling, shooting, and puzzle solving are all here and better than ever, arguably making this the pinnacle of the Uncharted series. Yakuza 0 was a game that put Yakuza on the map for many gamers outside of Japan. It's also the perfect place for newcomers to start. Mixing high-stakes crime drama and absurdist comedy, Yakuza 0 follows the origins of Yakuza legends Kiryu Kazuma and Goro Majima as they get mixed up in a mafia land grab. The combat is simple but uses over-the-top action moves to keep everything moving at a bombastic pace. The game also packs in a slew of hilarious and heartbreaking character moments, wacky side stories, and an immersive Japanese city full of minigames. This game is a result of the Yakuza team firing on all cylinders, leading to one of the best installments in the entire series. The premise of Harvest Moon 64 is simple. Much like other games in the Harvest Moon and Story of Seasons series, a young farmer must restore his grandfather's property to its former glory in just a couple of years. Of course, he'll also have the help of an entire town of characters, and he might even meet the love of his life along the way. Though the game was released in 1999, modern gamers still believe Harvest Moon 64 more than holds up against more recent farming games, thanks mostly to its charming art style and excellent writing. Despite the quick turnaround time between Fallout 3 and Fallout New Vegas, many fans regard the latter as a huge improvement in terms of lore, character building, and quest design.
Try not to smile so wide, baby, you might break your mouth.
In this game, players take on the role of a courier who was shot in the head and left for dead during a confrontation with bandits. Saved by nothing more than blind luck and a country doctor, the courier goes on to involve themselves in numerous political and violent conflicts that are raging across the Mojave wasteland. Featuring an intricate faction system and multiple ways to approach every quest, Fallout New Vegas is an unforgettable role-playing experience. A strategy adventure title, Pikmin rides a fine line between stress and relaxation, as serene environments are contrasted against a tense battle for survival. Stranded on planet PNF-404, Olimar befriends a race of alien creatures known as Pikmin. Together, they seek parts of Olimar's ship so that he can return home, and they have only 30 days to finish the job. To collect each part of the ship, Pikmin are delegated to join combative or carrying squads. As the game gets more difficult, the player will have to pay closer attention to strategy and planning. By the end of the game, they will have mastered this style of high-stakes micromanagement. It doesn't come easily, but it's a heck of a gratifying feeling. Tekken 3 didn't invent the fighting game genre, but it pretty much perfected it. This 1998 release also showed that console ports of arcade games could be just as good as the originals, and delivered one of the most satisfying gameplay formulas of all time. A design structure that's so good, it has barely changed in decades. Whether you played Tekken 3 in arcades when it first released on the original PlayStation, or even years later, it almost certainly made a lasting impression on you, and even today, the game is just too much fun to put down. StarCraft II follows the same basic formula as the original game, putting players in control of one of three different spacefaring armies and setting them to battle against each other. With the sequel, Blizzard stepped up every aspect of the original, from combat mechanics to graphics to level design. StarCraft II also came out at the perfect time, meeting the growing demand for competitive games in the burgeoning esports community. The game's moment of dominance has long since passed, of course, and fans have been left wondering if they'll ever get another sequel. But there can be no question about Blizzard's place in the history of esports. A gritty, retro-futuristic action-adventure game set inside the sunken city of Rapture, BioShock combines elements of first-person shooter gameplay with a style of immersive storytelling told through the discovery of recordings and letters. Back when it was released in 2007, GamesRadar said the only downside to the title was that it eventually had to end, and that it wasn't certain if it would ever receive a sequel. Luckily, there's not one but two other Bioshock games for fans to enjoy, after they check out the adventure that started it all.
Nico, it's Roman. Want to go bowling?
Grand Theft Auto 4 abandoned many of the quirkier aspects of previous entries and replaced them with a more involving and human story. It may have been a risk for a franchise like this, but GTA 4 more than stuck the landing. All the boroughs of Liberty City are distinct, emulating a living, breathing New York City, one that is filled with engaging side activities such as dates and hangouts. Nico is a great protagonist too, given a serious story featuring some of the best writing in the franchise. It may not have been the runaway success of GTA 5, but this installment is absolutely worthy of the Grand Theft Auto franchise's shining reputation. Fans have found a variety of ways to enjoy Animal Crossing New Horizons, and part of the beauty of the game is that it allows for so many different styles of play. You really can do pretty much anything you like. One thing that helped make New Horizons a lasting favorite for many gamers is its consistent free updates. For almost 2 years, each new season has brought with it retooled fish and plants, as well as new additions to the base game itself, such as a coffee shop and art gallery. Although one of the more recent additions to New Horizons came with an extra price tag, the title's dedication to keeping things fresh will no doubt keep fans invested for years to come. 2018's God of War is a soft reboot that plays differently from the rest of the franchise. This version of the game adopts an open-ended world design that focuses on exploration, light RPG mechanics, and over-the-shoulder action. However, despite these changes, the game is no less frantic or enjoyable than its predecessors, and the rejigged story, which does away with the standard revenge plot and focuses on Kratos' attempts to be a good father, only makes the game that much more interesting. Honestly, if the upcoming God of War Ragnarok is even half as good as 2018's God of War, players might have a Game of the Year contender on their hands. Where to start with Metal Gear Solid? You could talk about how it launched Hideo Kojima, one of the most visionary and influential game designers of all time, to international acclaim. Or mention how its heavy use of voice acting and cinematic cutscenes raised the standards for video game storytelling. You could even mention the successful sequels and spin-offs it spawned, the carefully crafted boss fights, or how the design of Shadow Moses Island made for a stealth setting unlike any other. Or of course, you could simply go play it and enjoy one of the greatest gaming experiences of the 1990s.
Snake, are you okay? Snake? Snake!
Taking cues from H.P. Lovecraft and gothic horror, the world of Bloodborne is incredibly disturbing. There's an air of hopelessness driving every encounter, from the horrid environments to the boss battles, which can be intimidating and huge in scope. In fact, the bosses are one of the best parts of both the base game and Old Hunters DLC. While some fans might prefer the bona fide Souls games, which are made by the same developer, there can be no question that Bloodborne is as gripping and terrifying as the rest of them. System Shock 2 is a unique FPS/RPG/horror hybrid. Even though the game looks dated, this title still creeps audiences out to this day thanks to its clever level designs, disturbing enemies, pitch-perfect soundscape, and spine-tingling journal entries. Now, the game isn't for everyone, and it can be downright unforgiving at times. Still, many video games that try new ideas don't always succeed, and to its credit, System Shock 2 certainly did. More importantly, it became one of the most influential titles in video game history, enjoying a legacy that stretches right up to the present day. Originally part of the Mother series, Earthbound was a total bomb that became a cult classic after US fans discovered its many lovable quirks. The mechanics of Earthbound aren't what makes the game an oddball classic. Instead, it's the enemies that set it apart. Throughout their journey, Ness and his friends encounter piles of vomit, roaches, and glossy aliens threatening the world, all ready to beat the crew into the ground. While cute, Earthbound is also incredibly difficult, presenting just as much of a challenge to gamers today as it did when it first released. Perhaps that's why it has remained a touchstone for JRPG fans, even after all these years. While the 90s were a rich era for video games, the graphics in Donkey Kong Country were more polished than many of its peers, even though it might be hard to imagine now. Additionally, Donkey Kong Country forged a playstyle that would boost its sequel to soaring heights. There's also something to be said for the game's play options. Gamers can pair up with a friend to work as a team, play against each other as rivals, or take on the title's single-player mode. And sure, the story might not be winning any awards, but fans will always have a soft spot for Donkey Kong Country's irresistible gameplay and zany cast of enemies. Tetris is simply iconic in every sense of the word. The title has seen many iterations over the years, and its pattern tetrominoes are instantly recognizable to most people, even those who don't consider themselves gamers. The premise of Tetris is almost painfully simple. You've got to fit differently shaped blocks together to form solid lines, which disappear after completion. If the massive bricks reaches the top of the screen, the game is over. Even though the game is easy to understand, it's difficult to master, and it teaches its players to see patterns long after they put down their controllers. Truly, Tetris is the stuff of legends. It's easy to see what made The Witcher 3 so popular. Upon its release, IGN praised the game's open-world design, commenting that, even though some of the early quests seemed repetitive, there was always something interesting to explore off the beaten path.
Will you help me if I bring the goat back?
The Witcher 3 wasn't the first open-world fantasy game, but it was one of the titles that made players understand what makes the genre so appealing. With delightfully strange characters and creatures around every corner, not to mention a lush and winding mythology, The Witcher 3 stands out as the entry that forever changed both The Witcher franchise and the action RPG genre. When it was released in 2000, The Sims was almost entirely unique. Many Maxis-produced Sim titles came before The Sims, allowing players to build entire cities and even species. But The Sims put players in charge of people with actual lives for the very first time. The Sims allowed players to dream up their own stories and their own worlds, and it functioned as a pretty nifty architectural tool too. In many ways, The Sims was like a virtual dollhouse, giving gamers the ability to create and recreate homes and individuals to their heart's content, if they had the simoleons, of course. League of Legends has a reputation as Riot Games' flagship franchise and one of the earliest esports to emerge into the public eye. This free-to-play multiplayer online battle arena game boasts over 140 heroes, each with their own unique personalities and playstyle. The game is also easy to play with friends, without having to commit too much money. That may be why League of Legends is both one of the most played PC games and most watched esports. Indeed, there's a real feeling of satisfaction to be found in finally pulling together the right combo, interacting with newly released League content, or simply meeting up with friends in-game. Diablo 2 is an incredibly addictive combination of RPG elements, fast-paced combat, and more loot than a bag of holding could handle. Choosing to control either a barbarian, necromancer, paladin, sorceress, or Amazon, the player wanders the world of Sanctuary, battling the undead and endless legions of demons from hell. All the while, they're showered in gold, gems, and new gear to constantly upgrade their abilities and overall damage output. Players also have the option of bringing in up to three friends to help them rid the land of evil and defeat the titular Demon Lord. Be warned, though, your computer's mouse left button may very well not survive the intense gameplay style of Blizzard's dungeon-crawling masterpiece. Elden Ring, from Software's latest masterpiece, evolves the Dark Souls formula while drawing on the endless replayability of massive sandbox RPGs. The result, one of the best releases of the last few years.
Together we'll devour the very core.
Elden Ring is tough as nails too, and the lands between are full of creatures that will happily demolish you. But the game counters its difficulty by giving you near-endless options for fine-tuning your combat build. The bosses are also some of the best in the studio's history, and the art design in the back half of the game puts pretty much everything else in the genre to shame. Persona games usually start with the protagonist as a new kid in town, but Persona 5 introduces the protagonist on harsher terms. The Joker isn't in Tokyo because he wants to be. He was wrongly accused of assault after attempting to help the victim. Everyone in the academy is wary of him from the start, which makes it fitting that he gradually befriends the other misfits in town. To that end, the story, characters, and general setup set this game apart from the usual hijinks of past Persona games, while keeping their spirit of youthful adulthood alive. Persona 5 also offers stylistic, satisfying turn-based combat and interactions that a skilled player can take advantage of, but it's fair to say that the narrative is the biggest highlight for both fans and critics.
I can do this all day.
Yeah, I know. I know.
Marvel vs. Capcom 2 broke the mold for crossover fighting games. Players composed tag teams of three characters from Marvel Comics and Capcom video games and pitted them against each other in chaotic tag team battles. It was a huge arcade success that eventually came to Dreamcast before being ported over to more modern consoles, including the PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. Unfortunately, Marvel vs. Capcom 2 is a difficult game to buy at a reasonable price, and the series has been left up in the air thanks to some pesky rights issues. Only time will tell whether Marvel vs. Capcom 2 will be given some kind of official comeback. But in the meantime, it certainly makes its mark on the fighting game world. The original Doom had it all, even from the very beginning. Everything about it blazed the trail for first-person shooters, from the genius map design to John Carmack's original Doom engine, which has been retroactively recognized as the first version of id Tech. This engine has allowed the game to live on through new mods and community content even decades after its release. Not only is Doom a foundational text in gaming, but fighting demons on Mars still feels fantastic. Each weapon in the 1993 shooter feels unique and powerful, and each level builds upon the last one and challenges the players in new and unexpected ways. Doom is still fast, challenging, and luckily available on any platform you could possibly imagine. The original Super Mario Bros. Is up there with the most famous titles in all of gaming history. Released for the NES, the game introduced the world to a superb platforming experience that is every bit as fun to play through today as it was in 1985. An entire generation of gamers has the levels, secrets, and shortcuts of Super Mario Bros. Permanently burned into their memories. Over the years, Nintendo has updated graphics and introduced new mechanics throughout multiple entries in the series, but the core gameplay remains virtually unchanged. It's just that good. The third entry in the Fallout series definitely deserves its spot at the top of the franchise, and its place among the best games of all time. The game follows a Vault Dweller embarking into the Capital Wasteland for the first time. Once in the world, it's up to players to choose their own path, joining sides with a variety of different factions and alliances as they search for a fabled invention that could save the world. When Fallout 3 first released, critics praised the game for serving as a major turning point for the series, as well as for video games in general. They also lauded the game's most memorable quality, its witty, endlessly entertaining writing. Even years later, this is still one of the most innovative and best-written games around. Resident Evil 4 was a bold risk for a stagnating horror franchise, and one that paid off as one of the finest action games ever made. Credited as one of the games that set the stage for the cover shooter fad of the Xbox 360 era, Resident Evil 4 proved that the behind-the-back camera was the future of console shooters. From this brand new perspective, you played as Leon S. Kennedy, on a mission to rescue the president's daughter in a rural village overrun by zombified monsters.
I've been expecting you, my brethren.
No thanks, bro.
Resident Evil 4 has tight shooting, creepy thrills, and a cast of memorable campy characters to keep you entertained throughout its totally nonsensical story. These elements combine with some of the most fearsome enemies in Resident Evil history to make one of the very best games in the series. To say The Legend of Zelda: The Wind Waker was controversial at the time of release is something of an understatement. Fans took particular issue with the new cel-shaded style of graphics. Today, though, both the original release and its remaster counterpart are beloved. The hook of the game is its ocean setting, and sailing the vast sea is simply thrilling. Exploring each island is key to the gameplay, while meeting the game's ally characters can give some extra flair to the classic dungeon puzzles. Although once seriously disliked by the Zelda fanbase, Wind Waker has proven to be a timeless iteration of one of gaming's greatest franchises. Super Mario Galaxy may have reinvented the wheel, but Super Mario Galaxy 2 refined the formula to perfection. As a sequel, it doesn't waste time. Rosalina's observatory is replaced by a spaceship resembling Mario, which freely travels through the level select screen, making for a more streamlined adventure. The game was also lauded for its creative ideas. New abilities for Yoshi and 2D sections are just a few highlights, helping to differentiate this title from other 3D platformers of the time. None of these big ideas outstay their welcome, though, as Super Mario Galaxy 2 constantly wants to show its players what other surprises are in store.
50,000 people used to live in the city. Now it's a ghost town. Never seen anything like it.
The release of Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare changed the entire landscape of the FPS genre forever. Cinematic campaigns, progressive multiplayer unlocks and class customization, prestiging, all these and more became commonplace after Modern Warfare was released. On the single-player ends, the game delivers an urgent and thrilling main campaign that features some of the most popular levels in the whole franchise. But the real lasting impact of Call of Duty 4 is in the multiplayer, which revolutionized the industry with its addictive system of perks, challenges, unlocks, and level-ups. Even outside of the first-person shooter genre, the Modern Warfare system quickly became the norm. Few games can reach the level of success that Grand Theft Auto V has obtained. While its story mode is grand enough on its own, Rockstar truly changed the game with GTA Online. Creating a character and grinding for money to buy weapons, cars, and other gear can be seriously addictive. But what keeps players coming back is the consistent content that Rockstar puts out, with additions such as the Diamond's Casino and the Contract constantly upping the stakes. Still, many fans have come to know GTA V best through its main campaign, which features three playable characters and a map based off of Los Angeles. As a whole, GTA V feels like a genuinely limitless game, even years after it first came out. Super Smash Bros. Melee has grown to be one of the most beloved fighting games of all time. It expanded on the cast of characters featured in Super Smash Bros. And revised its mechanics to what GamerWeb Nintendo called near perfection. The fan community has gone above and beyond too, even forming a dedicated developer team that has made the game available to play for PC with rollback netcode. It's also popular enough that there are still regular Melee tournaments even after two decades. And of course, this is also the game that paved the way for all the other successful installments in the franchise. Taking place decades before the first game, Metal Gear Solid 3 allowed players to take control of Big Boss, the man whose DNA was used to create Solid Snake. From the Bond-style opening to the stylish camouflage options, the game is masterful at setting its tone and keeping you invested, no matter how silly it gets. And it gets pretty silly.
The pain! The pain!
Metal Gear Solid 3 is the pinnacle of this iconic stealth action series. The bosses are consistently creative and the survival-style gameplay is incredibly innovative. But above all else, the story is simply superb, building at a thrilling pace to one of the most heart-wrenching endings of all time. Perhaps the most masterful example of psychological horror in gaming, Silent Hill 2 still holds its pyramid head-shaped crown over 20 years after its release. In this second entry in Konami's once-esteemed Silent Hill franchise, James Sunderland goes searching for his missing wife and winds up in the foggy unreality of Silent Hill. The story and atmosphere still hold an eerie weight in Silent Hill 2. And the off-the-wall voice acting only adds to the feeling that these characters are symbols and stand-ins for parts of James's fractured psyche. Sure, the controls and puzzles might be a little clunky by today's standards, but Silent Hill 2 is dense in terms of meaning, if not actual content. In some ways, The Elder Scrolls V: Skyrim created the blueprint for truly open-world games. It's not too much of a stretch to say that, without it, there would be no Elden Ring and no Breath of the Wild. And gamers are still enjoying Skyrim, even a decade after its original release. The title recently received an update via the Skyrim Anniversary Edition 2, which gave the aging game a facelift for next-gen systems. While some might argue that it's time to let Skyrim rest in the catacombs, it's clear there's still a demand for the game, and a new generation of players to enjoy it.
Fus-ro-da!
I didn't catch that.
Fus-ro-da!
I didn't quite catch that.
Fus-ro-da!
Retro Studios delivered one of the greatest games of all time in Metroid Prime. A densely packed adventure through lush alien environments, Prime perfectly captured the series' core tenets of the franchise – exploration, solitude, and discovery. Anchored by groundbreaking visuals and an absolutely gorgeous soundtrack, Metroid Prime is nearly as fun to watch as it is to play. It sent the series in an exciting new direction, gathered a whole array of new fans to the franchise, and delivered a truly killer app to the GameCube. One that's still worth playing today. World of Warcraft is a quintessential MMO. Released in 2004, the game reached over 12 million monthly subscribers at its peak in 2010. Its subscriber count has come down dramatically since then, but it says a lot that the World of Warcraft servers are still active almost 20 years after the game's release. Everything people love about MMOs was perfected by Blizzard's masterpiece. Players embark on quests that take them all over a giant open world, using hotkey-based combat to slay enemies, earn XP, and upgrade their gear and abilities. The backbone of the game is formed by huge raids, which usually revolve around dungeon showdowns or epic player-versus-player battles. It's a simple concept, sure, but it's also frighteningly addictive. Halo 3 comes remarkably close to total perfection. The level and encounter designs are vast and distinct, hugely improving over the corridor crawls for which the series have become known. The combat was expanded in interesting ways with new weapons, vehicles, and deployable items, and the competitive multiplayer delivered the best PvP experience in the franchise. Even the co-op campaign felt more complete than in past games. And if all that wasn't enough, Halo 3 wraps up the original trilogy's story in a powerful and compelling way, with Master Chief well and truly finishing the fight. The fifth entry in the Zelda series was also the first to debut on the Nintendo 64. The game follows yet another version of Link as he journeys through a fantasy landscape and time itself on a mission to save Hyrule from the evil wizard Ganondorf. Ocarina of Time set a whole new standard for Zelda games, and just about every entry since has proudly worn the game's influence on its sleeve. From its combat system to level design, Ocarina of Time is so superb that some argue it's flat out the best game ever. Without a doubt, the game is a real high point for the Zelda series.
So wake up, Mr. Freeman. Wake up and smell the ashes.
Half-Life 2 was one of the essential shooters of the early 2000s. In the 20 years between the two games, the alien Combine Empire has come to dominate most of the planet Earth. So Gordon Freeman joins the fight against the Empire by solving a series of physics-based puzzles and wielding an array of fantastic weapons. Half-Life 2 isn't just renowned for its gorgeous visuals and incredibly fun combat mechanics. The game also has a great story filled with memorable characters. Unfortunately for fans, that story ends in a pretty huge cliffhanger. The world has been waiting almost 20 years for Half-Life 3. And despite releasing a VR spin-off title in 2020, it doesn't look like Valve will be delivering a true sequel anytime soon. Combining pitch-perfect melee combat mechanics and imperfect range mechanics with punishing difficulty, Dark Souls is so challenging that its Game of the Year re-release was called the Prepare to Die Edition. However, the more players were beat down by the nightmarish creatures of Dark Souls, the more they loved the game. In fact, the combat in this game is so good it spawned an entire subgenre of Souls-like titles. But it's not just tense combat that fans the flame of passion in its followers. The game also has a deeply intricate mythology told through item descriptions, snippets of dialogue, and clever world design. For over a decade, players have been falling in love with the game's many secrets and hidden stories. It's not often that a sequel is way better than the original. But Castlevania Symphony of the Night is one of those rare cases. The Castlevania series has a long history and has gone through multiple iterations of gameplay over the years. Symphony of the Night is a standout platforming title in the series, but it can also go toe-to-toe with any of the saga's 3D action-adventure entries. Though the game was initially a commercial failure, it has since become known as one of the most influential 2D platformers of all time. Street Fighter II was a game that really brought international recognition to this classic fighting series. The first Street Fighter II games appeared in arcades, and it later received home console ports, which grew the game's popularity even further. Super Street Fighter II Turbo and installments that incorporated new characters and mechanics later became the first title featured in what would become the Evolution Championship Series. It's now known as one of the most popular fighting game franchises in the world. Street Fighter II also inspired countless fighting games after it. Basically, if you've enjoyed any game involving colorful and powerful characters participating in an international fighting tournament, then you've got Street Fighter II to thank. Even though Rockstar Games wowed audiences with the Grand Theft Auto series, nobody expected the studio to perfect the formula in, of all things, a Wild West setting.
This place ain't no such thing as civilized.
Red Dead Redemption 2 is an open-world cowboy simulator filled with beautiful vistas, dastardly bandits, and enough side activities to create two more open-world games. Moreover, each game feature is tied together with the others in an almost unprecedented level of detail that elevates the adventure past any of its contemporaries. Virtually every aspect of Red Dead Redemption 2 is a work of art, but the truly amazing thing is how they all blend so seamlessly together, crafting an astonishing experience that is far greater than the sum of its parts. Minecraft is such a big deal that it inspired an entire genre of world-building games with its cute voxel style. Even though it was released years ago, the game has stayed relevant to its fanbase by releasing consistent free updates and giving players the ability to create almost anything they want. Most remarkably of all, Minecraft has crossed into wider pop culture, selling a ton of merch and even securing an upcoming movie adaptation. Its popularity seems to be unwavering with both kids and adults alike too. Props to the game that built an empire. The first thing you'll notice about Shadow of the Colossus is that it has some of the most beautiful visuals that ever graced the PlayStation 2. In terms of gameplay, the title is essentially a series of massive boss battles. Players travel across a vast open world in search of giant creatures known as Colossi that must be scaled and attacked at hidden weak points. The gameplay alone would be enough to land Shadow of the Colossus a place in the top 10, but it also boasts one of the most memorable stories in gaming. The game's narrative is straightforward but emotional, understated but punctuated by a twist that will leave your jaw on the floor when the credits roll. Shadow of the Colossus really is an absolute masterpiece. Pokemon Fire Red and Leaf Green were the first two remakes of the original games, Pokemon Red and Blue. It might not seem like much at first, but the greatly refined graphics, mechanics, and endgame content really boosted these games above their predecessors. And sure, Fire Red and Leaf Green may not have been revolutionary in terms of plot or introducing brand new content, but they're certain to be commended for how effectively they improved what was already a solid premise. Chrono Trigger is one of the most celebrated JRPGs ever made, in part because each member of its dream team of devs went on to lead other beloved RPG series, such as Final Fantasy and Dragon Quest. But what makes the game itself so special? As it turns out, everything. In addition to clever combat mechanics, Chrono Trigger features a twist-filled story that, at one point, forces players to totally refigure both their party composition and the trajectory of the story. The game also features a diverse cast of well-developed characters, as well as player decisions that actually make a difference in the game's plot. Add in a stunning soundtrack by legendary Final Fantasy composer Nobuo Uematsu, and you've got a title that will stand firm against the wings of time. From gameplay to storytelling, Final Fantasy VII truly shines. The materia system allows players to customize their party in extreme detail, while still keeping everything strikingly simple. The soundtrack from Nobuo Uematsu is arguably his best ever. And more than anything, the world of FF7 grips the player from the very beginning. Final Fantasy VII delivers what every RPG attempts, a truly epic story in a deep and lived-in world, culminating in one of the most iconic showdowns in video game history.
Gotta go fast!
There's a lot to be said for the impact and influence of the original Sonic the Hedgehog, the colorful worlds of Sonic 3, and the time travel mechanics of Sonic CD. However, out of all the classics, Sonic the Hedgehog 2 is the one most deserving of a place at the top. Where the first game showed the potential in high-speed platforming, Sonic 2 mastered it, cleaning up levels to help players keep their momentum going and adding the Hedgehog's signature spin dash as an easy method of acceleration. From the addition of Tails to fan-favorite levels like Chemical Plant Zone, Sonic 2 nailed all the details, ultimately delivering the best entry the series has ever had. Super Metroid is a certified classic. In 1994, it pushed gaming forward and reinvented the Metroid formula forever. Today, it holds up as the foundational text of the namesake Metroidvania genre, and remains as tense and engaging as the day it was released. Each of the game's areas has its own distinct visual identity, and it also features one of the best soundtracks in gaming. There are so many ways to play too, from speedrunning to sequence breaking the whole dang thing. No wonder so many people think this is the best game in the Metroid series. Valve's Portal might have introduced the inventive puzzle formats and sassy robot overlord GLaDOS, but Portal 2 expanded the narrative in a way many gamers didn't anticipate, complete with a superb and star-studded cast. While Portal and Portal 2 are technically connected to Valve's other famous franchise, Half-Life, players don't need to have played any other games to understand the gist of GLaDOS's infamous physics tests. In fact, Portal 2 is pretty much perfect all on its own. It is hard to believe that Naughty Dog's groundbreaking The Last of Us is nearly 10 years old. This modern classic takes recognizable literary and cinematic genre elements and brings them to the world of video games, in an emotional ride like no other before. The methodic shooting and scrounging gameplay was visceral and arresting compared to everything Naughty Dog had tried before it, and it still holds up today. The world of the game is bleak, sure, but it's also full of so many well-realized characters that many gamers will be more than glad to see the brutal story to its shocking conclusion. Breath of the Wild quite literally changed the Legend of Zelda games forever. While previous installments in the series have broken the mold by switching to 3D graphics or utilizing motion controls in new ways, Breath of the Wild created an open-world experience like no other. Players could complete dungeons in any order they chose, interacting with NPCs and hoofing it across Hyrule as they pleased. With a quirky cast and a story packed full of the mythology Zelda titles are known for, there's little to dislike about Breath of the Wild. And with a staggering 97 on Metacritic and rave reviews from critics and fans alike, this open-world Zelda classic remains one of the best games on the Nintendo Switch, and one of the best games of all time. It's hard to imagine what games would be like without Super Mario 64, the title that single-handedly revolutionized 3D gaming. The game's now iconic levels are a marvel by themselves, but the surprisingly smooth platforming and easygoing controls are the real stars of the show. The sandbox-like design was way ahead of its time, too, and the whole experience still feels polished, even a quarter of a century later. Super Mario 64 truly is a bona fide masterpiece, one that helped popularize the concept of speedrun and successfully reinvented both the Mario franchise and video games as a whole.